to be connected to him to be fulfilled. Your fulfillment in life can simply be in God. Everything that is created needs to stay connected to its source. But when God was about to create man, he didn't speak to the ground and he didn't speak to the water. He said, let us create man in our image and our likeness. Hello friends, it's a pleasure and a privilege to be with you. We are excited here at Tabernacle of Glory. March is the month of supernatural breakthrough, and we get our up to our supernatural breakthrough by following the counsel of the Lord today. Number one, according to Jeremiah chapter 23, verse 18. According to Jeremiah chapter 23, verse 18, what is the counsel of the Lord? According to Jeremiah chapter 23, verse 18, read it and try to answer that question. What is the counsel of the Lord? Take 15 minutes and then I'm going to come back with you guys so we can move on to the next question.
que pour bon j'ai parlé avec qui veut parler avant qui veut parler avant
Again, now we're talking about the spirit of counsel. According to 1 Samuel 28, verse 6, what are three ways that God can speak to us. According to 1 Samuel chapter 28, verse 6, what are three ways that God can speak to us, that the spirit of counsel can reveal himself to us? So take 3 minutes to discuss those three different ways, and then we'll come right back to move on with you guys. Again, with the spirit of counsel, in 1 Samuel chapter 28, verse 6, we are talking about the Urim, and that the Urim represents the Holy Spirit of God in our lives. Now, have you ever received a red light, a yellow light, or a green light from the Holy Spirit? Have you ever received a red light, a yellow light, or a green light from the Holy Spirit? And how did it feel? And what happened when you obeyed or disobeyed? When you received a red, green, or yellow light from the Lord, how did it feel? And how did it, what happened? Whether you obeyed or disobeyed, what happened? So take 15 minutes and then we'll come right back to close.
Thank you. Thank you.
That last part of our time together is that we're going to pray for one another. We have talked about the counsel of the Lord. The counsel of the Lord is that group in heaven where the Lord sits and makes special decisions. And the Bible says those who are close to him, he allows you to know the decisions that are made in heaven. So take a little time right now. In Jeremiah chapter 23, verse 18, he said, if they had stood in the counsel of God, pray for one another so you can stand in the counsel of God. Pray for one another as well so that all of your spiritual lights, whether they are red light or yellow light or green light, can be functioning in a way that is honoring to the Lord. So take the next 15 minutes to pray for one another, and we'll come back to close. Thank you. Well, friends, indeed, it was a pleasure to be with you guys. May the Lord bless you. I'm going to be waiting for you guys next week at church. We're going to continue teaching on the spirit of counsel, how it applies to different aspects in our lives. And remember to start planning and praying for your Andrew Operation friend for next month. I want to thank all of you who participated. We had a great response. Thank you for participating. And next month, and first Sunday of April, we'll get together to do the same thing. God bless you. You got to be connected to Him to be fulfilled. Your fulfillment in life can simply be in God. Everything that is created needs to stay connected to its source. But when God was about to create man, He didn't speak to the ground and He didn't speak to the water. He said, "Let us create